Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today's recipe is Shahi Paneer. This turns out to be extremely creamy, delicious and tasty. Very easy to make, perfect for beginners. So without any further ado, let's get started. We'll start by preparing the masala for the gravy, for which heat up a pan and add in 3 tablespoons of oil. Here I'm using olive oil, you can use any cooking oil that is available with you. Then to this add in 2 roughly chopped onions. Give them a good stir and cook them on low to medium flame until they turn nice and brown. Here I've chopped the onions roughly because they will be grinded afterwards. You can chop them in any which ways you want. The more you roast them, the more flavorful they will be. Then add in 1 inch grated ginger and 2 slit green chilies. Further cook them for 1 minute on low to medium flame. Then add in 2 roughly chopped tomatoes and cook them for 2 to 3 minutes on low medium flame until they turn nice and soft. Make sure to stir in between occasionally, otherwise it will stick to the pan and burn. Once the onions are done, add in some salt according to your taste, 1 teaspoon of coriander or dhania powder, 1/2 teaspoon of haldi powder, 1/2 teaspoon of degi mirch powder, this gives an awesome color to your gravy, and 1/3 teaspoon of red chili powder. Do not add a lot of red chili powder because we are also using garam masala and green chilies in this. Give all the spices a good mix. Make sure the flame is on low, otherwise the spices will burn. Now add water as required. A quick tip, pour it from the top of your spatula so that all the masala goes directly into the pan. Give it a good stir, cover and let it cook for 3 to 4 minutes. It's very important for the spices to cook perfectly. Here you can see that all the water has been dried, which means the masala is ready. Let it cool completely and then transfer it to a blending jar. Do not use it hot, otherwise the blending jar might burst open. Now to this add in 1/4 cup of milk and blend it into a smooth puree. Here you can see I've blended it into a smooth puree and the color looks so beautiful. To the same pan add 1 tablespoon of oil and 1 tablespoon of butter. Butter is completely optional, but it will give an extremely creamy taste to your Shahi Paneer. Once it's nice, hot and melted, add in 1/4 teaspoon of degi mirch powder and 1/4 teaspoon of salt. Degi mirch powder is not very spicy, it's just used for the color. So don't be afraid in adding it. Give the spices a good mix and then add in your gravy. You will hear the gravy sizzle and it looks tempting already. Give it a good mix. Make sure the flame is on low to medium. Once the spices are nicely mixed, add in 1/4 cup of water to thin down the gravy a little bit and mix well. Then add in 200 grams of cubed paneer. Here I've cut the paneer into large triangles. You can also cut them in cubes or rectangles. Here I've taken 1/4 cup of cashew nuts and 1/4 cup of milk. We are going to blend it into a smooth puree. This is the secret ingredient for this recipe. This will give this an extremely creamy and rich taste. You can see the gravy is nice and bubbling now. To this add in your cashew paste and mix it. Enjoy the beauty of cooking. You will see beautiful white ripples forming into your gravy. Be very delicate, otherwise the paneer will break. Then on a separate tawa or a pan, add 2 tablespoons of kasuri methi. Roast it on low to medium flame until it's nice and aromatic. Do not over roast it, otherwise it will become bitter. Then take it out onto a plate and crush it with the help of your hands. This gives an extremely tasty taste, yet a very beautiful aroma to your Shahi Paneer. Now add in your crushed kasuri methi 1/4 teaspoon of garam masala powder and 2 split green chilies. Give them a good mix. Make sure that while you're adding the kasuri methi, rub it between your palms. Then, here I'm using 3 to 4 tablespoons of malai. You can also use cream. All I've done here is I've taken the homemade malai and blended it with a little bit of milk. This does not make the shahi paneer very heavy. And here you go. Your tasty and delicious creamy shahi paneer is ready. Serve it hot with a garnishing of grated paneer on top. A dollop of butter and a sprinkling of kasuri methi. Doesn't it look delicious and tempting? Do give this recipe a try and make sure to comment down below all your feedbacks. If you like this recipe, then make sure to subscribe to my channel. Press the bell icon so that you get notified every time I post a new video. Give it a big fat thumbs up and comment down below how do you like this recipe. I'll see you next time. Thanks for watching.